You know, it's an interesting question about email. People talk about how you deal with all that volume. And I say, well, people have estimated you have 50,000 thoughts a day. How are you dealing with that? Right? 50,000, 300's nothing. You got 50,000 to deal with. How are you dealing with that? So again, I don't want to be facetious about it, but the truth is everybody's getting all kinds of input all the time. And email is no more different than any other input people have implicitly allowed to come into their psyche. The difference really is that what's riding across email, as opposed to, oh, there's a thought about a tree, there's a thought about my mother. What's riding across email is an implicit agreement that there's something in there I might still need to decide or do something about. And now, if you have a thought about your mother flipping through, and you know there's something you need to decide or do something about, ain't any different than an email that's showing up. So again, email is merely just a reflection of a lot of undecided things that people have implicitly allowed to kind of hook into their psyche in some way that they know they still need to do something with. What our training is about is there's no difference about how you deal with email than how you deal with a thought in your mind about, oh, I should do something about mom, than it is a piece of paper that lands in your mail. I got to decide what it is, what does it mean, what I'm going to do about it. It's just you need to get a lot faster about it because now you're letting a lot more of those options show up in your life and they're coming at you a lot faster. So you can get faster at the process, you know, in terms of that. And yeah, at some point you just want to turn the spigot off or detour it, say, well, I don't need to get these emails. So again, those choices are also up to you, but easier said than done, because now that the world is sort of caught that they can catch everybody, you know, from my experience, most of the BlackBerry usage, not all of it, but a lot of the BlackBerry usage is because people aren't dealing with their email. So people now need a louder horn. Hey, now I'm going to stick it on your belt and buzz you every time you get an email because you ain't dealing with it when we send it the other way. And I go, well, there's no light at the end of that tunnel either. You know, at some point they're going to get a bigger, louder BlackBerry that's going to go like that because you're not dealing with this one. So where's the end of that? Well, the end of it is, again, getting back to the elegance of the executive process, called how fast do you get of input coming in, and that starts to then make you more conscious and more mature about what input you're allowing to begin with.